Good morning on Wednesday the 16th of August. You'll note that I have the short sleeve jacket on today. This is with optimism that it might be a bit warmer and sunnier. I open prayer. Loving Lord, we are aware of our human shortcomings. We ask that by your Holy Spirit you give us strength to work for that which is good through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today our readings are Psalm 77 and Jeremiah 40, chapter 43. When something happens which is way beyond our expectations, we are absolutely delighted. But then we sometimes begin to wonder, is this too good to be true? What's the twist? God has made an unusual provision for the Israelites, so unusual that they really do need to truly trust him. And we read that instead of giving thanks to God for his unexpected blessing, they start to wonder about the catch. As a reminder, the unexpected provision involves the Babylonians allowing the poor to stay in Jerusalem as a remnant of the people, and also giving land to them. This is so different from what they had expected the Babylonians to do, and they struggle to accept that this is happening. Despite previous assurances from God, they seek some sort of confirmation from him about what it is they should do. Once again, God says, stay where you are. But their distrust of the Babylonians is so great that they decide that is so great, and that is despite the fact that God is using them to be part of his sovereign plan. Because it's Jeremiah who's passing on this message from God, they turn on him and they say that he's lying. Although they have been told that it will be safe to stay in Jerusalem, they round up everyone and lead them into Egypt. And that includes Jeremiah, who throughout has done exactly what God has told him to do, including staying in Jerusalem, despite having other options. Let's not forget, for this time at least, God is using the Babylonians as his servants, and he actually refers to them as such. He says that in due course the Babylonians will continue and will conquer Egypt, and that's the very place that the Israelites are going to because they think they'll be safe. Again, all very complicated and all very second-guessing and reading into a situation, things which aren't there. Today we're going to use our community prayer. Loving Lord, we thank you that you are already everywhere. We pray for the area of Mill Hill, Gallagher's, Bank Top and Woody. We think of everyone who lives in them, all who work there, and those who pass through these areas in their daily lives. We ask that you give us the eyes to see your vision for these places. Amen. Our prayer points today are linked to relationships. Let's start by praying for our relationships with God and with family and friends. Then pray for relationships between communities and within the communities where we live, and to pray about international relationships, especially where there is war and tension at present. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Hopefully, I finished in plenty of time for you all to prepare yourselves for yet another potential roller coaster watching England's ladies' football team. I've commented recently to a friend that I think they've picked up bad habits from the England men's team. And that bad habit is giving us nervous anxiety while watching them. We didn't struggle with that last summer. However, I do hope that those of you who watch the match enjoy it. And our blessing for today, the peace of God which passes all understanding, a peace which the world cannot give, be in your hearts and your minds, in your homes and your communities. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and